So let me kind of give you the lay of the land of what you're looking at here. So I have P6, it's the latest version, 1912. And I have multiple projects inside my EPS structure. So you can use caps on one project or more than one. And in my example, I'm going to use it on more than one project at a time. Okay. You can control that. So we have a field that says, yes, I want to use caps, or no, I don't. Okay, so you can control which ones out of the gate you even want caps to look at and work with. Now, in terms of how you want to get somebody to look at the activities and do updates, we have two different mechanisms. So you can either use project level coding, saying in this case that Nicole is going to do the updates and Mary Lynn is going to do the updates on this project. Okay, so if your project is is managed in such a way that one person will do all the updates, then you can easily use this project level coding. Now you don't have to, you're not limited to that. So that's just one approach. And some of our clients, when it's the project manager that does the updates, this works very well. But if you have a little bit more of a complicated project, you may well want to use a different level. So I've got the example here where I've got different vendors who are going to do part of the work. Now you can see that I've got it filtered, so I can go ahead and unfilter that. And I'll take that vendor filter off. Okay, so you could just see that I can have multiple vendors. It's a responsibility code in essence that I've used to identify who's going to do the work. Now, I may choose to let these different vendors have a license of caps, and I can let them do their own updating if I wish. Okay, I don't have to, but I can. So that's one model. And when you're at a construction site, you may have not only a contractor doing the work, but you may have different crews that contractor has performing work out on the job site. Just like with your engineering companies, you may have different crews or different disciplines doing the engineering work. Okay, so these are just examples of some coding structures that I think you probably do in some way, shape, or form already that you can use to essentially filter and give over tasks in a controlled way. Now, CAPS uses P6's API or web service. That's the foundation of how we access the data in a secure manner. So if you've given a particular user only certain access to certain projects, EPS nodes, OBS nodes, we adhere to that as well as the very beginning point of access, if you will. Okay, so we don't go around any of that security that you would deploy first and foremost. So I have more than one project. So I've got a civil turbine, a piping reactor. Now these could be different components to a larger project if that's how you set your P6 up, or they could be distinct projects. Whichever way you want to keep you doing your P6, CAPS will adhere to that. So obviously I have some updating that I want done. You know, I've got, if I do my spotlight, and you can see in the next month, I have quite a few tasks that I'm expecting to get updated. That same sort of idea, I can get out there into CAPS and have these tasks updated from CAPS. So let me log into CAPS and then we'll start to look at what that looks like. Let me log out and I'll just log back in. So you can have CAPS working on more than one database. So if you're an engineering company, and you set up different databases for your clients, each one of your projects, because maybe you're administering that for your client, then you can certainly have it pointing to more than one database. This login is secured from P6, from the administration in P6. So I log in, and this is the user interface for CAPS. Now let me explain what you're looking at here. So I've logged in as Nicole J, and I have access to multiple projects. And let me just make this a little bit bigger so you can see it better. So I have multiple projects here, and I can certainly filter them. And I'll come back to that in a minute. And I have multiple tabs here. So what we've tried to do is give you all the things that you might want to update in P6. And that doesn't mean you have to use all these, but we've given you access to the activities or tasks, the resources, expenses, steps. Okay, so that's what you're seeing here. We've also given you information about successors and predecessors that just help you understand kind of what's happening with the logic on those activities. Those two tabs are view-only tabs. So we're not allowing any logic changes. It's just for the users to see it if you want them to, okay? Now we also have a little deviation approval window. So if you want to use approvals inside of CAPS, this is essentially the main window that someone would use to take a look and understand what they're approving. Now in here, we've got some variances so that you can see whether things are going well or maybe not coming together quite as you hoped, so that you have a better idea of exactly what you're approving. Okay. Now, you might say, well, I don't need all those things. I don't use steps. I don't use expenses. Or you might say, well, for some projects I use them and some projects I don't. Okay. So what we've also done here is we've got, in this latest version, we've added a lot of features about managing the views to make it more configurable for your different kinds of projects. So I can have different views. So in this, the one that I've logged in as, it was all tabs are being shown. But if I only need tasks, I can go ahead and pick that one and apply it. It lets me know, hey, just the task tab is being shown. And of course you always want that deviation tab. And then I can go ahead and work inside that tab. Now, some of you might have noticed, depending on whether you had your coffee this morning or not, that, hey, some activities were not on the screen anymore, which is okay because I've got a filter in here too. Okay, so in this example, I'm ready to run through the Engineering X company's updates because I've got a filter on there. Now, here I am. Maybe I'm going to do my updates with Engineering X in a meeting. So I could pop into my meeting portal, just like we're doing right now, a Zoom meeting or whatever you're using. And even though they're not going to do the updates themselves, I might be doing them for them. We're able to look at them and walk through it very simply in a meeting format here, where they're sharing the screen and they can see what I'm about to update, okay? So I also have some other fields on the screen to try and make it, you know, a little bit easier for me to know which activities are big showstoppers. So the first thing you might notice is we've got some that are critical. Okay, so that's an important one. Obviously, we don't want to forget to be talking about these critical ones. Now we've also configured a near critical. So this sort of yellowy orange is a near critical. And that's configurable in the background. Okay. So that we're not missing these important ones that you want to make sure you don't forget